بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم اللہم رب زدنی علما صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم آمین الحمدللہ رب العالمین. This lecture is of summary of transformations of functions. For this lecture, I am using the work of one of my best student, Ms. Laiba Gulzar of class 2021, the Lyceum. An important advice for me and for everyone: we should be nice to others. Transformations of functions types. There are three types of transformations of functions. Number one, translation. Number two, reflection. And number three, stretch. Translation is the displacement of the object only with respect to the given translation vector, for example AB, and we translate the object with respect to head to tail rule. This means horizontal component and this means vertical component. So if the translation vector is 2 and 3, then we have to shift object 2 units to the right and 3 units to the up. Reflection. In reflection, we get mirror image. Well, in both translation and reflection, the object and image are congruent. Stretch. In a stretch, object and image are neither congruent nor similar. And this is the formula of the stretch factor: image to invariant line distance divided by object to invariant line distance. While describing a stretch, you have to be careful regarding three things. Number one, you have to state which type of stretch is this. So what if object is stretched vertically, then you have to mention stretch parallel to y-axis or vertical stretch. Then you have to mention the stretch factor, whatever the stretch factor is. And then you have to mention the equation of the invariant line. In vertical stretch, x-axis is invariant. Its equation is y0. Horizontal stretch. Well, when object is stretched horizontally, then y-axis is invariant. An equation of y-axis is x0. For example, stretch factor is 2, and this is the equation of the object. So, to get the equation of the resulting graph or image, we need to replace this x by half x. The reciprocal of the stretch factor should be here. Make sure you, when a stretch is horizontal, then you replace this x by 1 upon stretch factor times x. If a stretch factor is 2, then 1 upon 2x. If a stretch factor is k, then use 1 upon kx here. An image size will be double horizontally. And this is the logic of this reciprocal stretch factor here. So if we have x comma y, if this is the object point, this will be the image point. You multiply this x with the stretch factor to get the x coordinate of the image. So the x coordinate of the image is a times stretch factor. A times x coordinate of the object. A is a stretch factor. For example, if we have 4 comma 3 and if this stretch factor is 2 and stretch is horizontal, then we need to multiply this stretch factor with this x coordinate to get the x coordinate of the image. So if the x coordinate of the image is red x, then it must be 2x with respect to this. Like, stretch factor times x coordinate of the object will give you the x coordinate of the image. This is here. This red x is here. So this is image and this is object. And in equation, we replace this x, the object's x. So we have to make this x subject. When we make this x subject, we'll get half x. That is why we have reciprocal of the stretch factor here. This is the logic of the reciprocal of the stretch factor. So make sure you, whenever stretch is horizontal, you always use reciprocal of the stretch factor here for the equation of the resulting graph. But for the coordinate of the image, you need to multiply x coordinate of the object with the same stretch factor, like 2. You don't need to reciprocal this here, because stretch factor 2 means image size will be double horizontally. So in general, we can say this, that if the stretch factor is A, then to get the coordinate of the image, we need to multiply x coordinate of object with the same stretch factor, AX. Make sure you multiply this x with the same stretch factor to get the x coordinate of the image. But for the equation of the resulting graph, you need to use reciprocal of the stretch factor because of this. Example, given horizontal stretch factor 1/3 and y-axis is invariant. So in horizontal stretch, for the equation of resulting graph, we use the reciprocal of the stretch factor. We will use 3x here. We need to replace all x occurrences in the equation of the object by 3x. So 3x. See, we use the reciprocal of 1/3 here, which is 3x, like 3. But for the coordinates of the image, we need to use the same stretch factor. We need to multiply x coordinate, this x coordinate, by the same stretch factor, 1/3. This is here. To get the equation, we use the reciprocal of the stretch factor. But to get the coordinates of the image, we use the same stretch factor. Make sure you do not mix these two things. Only in equation we use reciprocal, but for coordinates we use the same thing. Vertical stretch. In vertical stretch, invariant line is always x-axis, that is y0. What if the stretch factor is 2, and let's suppose the equation of the object is this. To get the equation of the resulting graph, we need to multiply this stretch factor with this f of x. We don't need to take reciprocal. We just need to multiply stretch factor with this to get the equation of the resulting graph. So this is the equation of the resulting graph. And to get the coordinates of the image, we need to multiply y coordinate of the object with the same stretch factor. This should be multiplied by 2. For example, if we have 5, 8, then it will become 5, 16. In vertical stretch, x coordinate will remain unchanged. This is the generalized form. So to get the coordinates of image, you should multiply y coordinate with the same stretch factor. And for the equation, you should multiply f of x with the same stretch factor. Example, vertical stretch factor 4, invariant line x-axis. And this is the equation of the object, and this is the object point. So we need two things. We need the equation of the resulting graph, and we need the coordinates of the image. We need to multiply this equation with this same stretch factor for the equation of the resulting graph. This is the equation of the resulting graph. 4 times this y, or f of x. So when you will simplify this, you will get the answer. I left this calculation for you. You have to simplify this. And for the coordinates of image, you should multiply this y coordinate of object with this same stretch factor 4. Reflection. There are two types of reflections in our syllabus. Number one, reflection about the x-axis. This means vertical transformation. Reflection about x-axis means when you reflect something about x-axis, then let's suppose this is the object point, then this will come here. So this is vertical transformation. And you change the y-coordinate, sine of y-coordinate. So to get the equation of the resulting graph, you should multiply f of x with the negative sign, because you change the sign of y coordinate. So this is the equation of the resulting graph. They both mean the same thing. So just change the sign of the y coordinate. If this is the object point, then this will be the image point. Just opposite the sign of y coordinate. Plus 3, minus 3. And how to get the equation? Very simple. This is the equation of the object. To get the equation of the image, you should multiply this y with negative 1 or negative sign. So this is the equation of the image. Just multiply this thing with negative sign. That's the answer. Type 2. Reflection about y-axis. This is horizontal transformation, because when you reflect anything about y-axis, then you change the sign of x-coordinate, and this is horizontal transformation. You just need to replace x by minus x. Replace this x by minus x to get the equation of the resulting graph, and change the x coordinate, sine of x coordinate, just opposite the sine of x coordinate. If this is 2, this will be minus 2. And how to get the equation of the resulting graph? This is very simple. You should replace this x by minus x. Make sure you must not multiply this whole equation by minus sign. Just replace x by minus x. This is same. So in reflection about x-axis, we multiply y by minus 1, like this. But in reflection about y-axis, we just need to replace x by minus x. And lines of reflections are fixed, that is only x and y-axis. Translation. This is the displacement of the object. This translation means horizontal translation. You have to shift the object A units to the right. And if this is the equation of the object, you need to replace this x by x minus a to get the equation of the image. This is the equation of the image. Replace x by x minus a. And this is the logic. See, this is the x of image, red x. And this is equal to this thing, x minus a. This is here. And let me explain this with this example, this way. See, this 4, 0 means, 4 and 0 means you need to shift this point 4 units to the right. So you need to add 4 into this x coordinate to get the x coordinate of the image, or to get the coordinates of image. So this x is this 2 plus 4, and if this is x, then x plus 4. So x of image is x of object plus translation vector, x component of translation vector. This thing is here. If the x component of translation vector is a, then this will become x plus a. So this thing is here in generalized form. But we replace this x to get the equation of the image or resulting graph. This x is here. So in order to replace this x, we need to make this x subject from this equation. So when we will make this x subject, we'll get this thing, x minus a, image minus a, x coordinate of image minus a. That is why we have opposite sign here. Let me explain this again. This is the x of the image, and we get this by adding translation, x component of translation vector into x coordinate of object. See, this is here, and this thing is here in generalized form. If a is 4, then this is a. But we replace object x to get the equation of the image or resulting graph. This x is here, and we need to replace this x. So we need to make this x subject from this equation. For that, we need to shift this a on left side. So this x is x minus a. So remember this. If we have positive a here, then we write negative a here. Opposite sign. What if we had negative a, then we had to write positive a here. The sign is always opposite. This is the example. So we need the coordinates of image. We just need to add this x component of translation vector into x coordinate of this image object. So 6 and 5. Now this is the translation, vertical translation, 0b, x component is 0. So if this is the equation of the object, then you just need to add this y component of this translation vector into this equation to get the equation of the resulting graph. This is the equation of the resulting graph. This is very simple. See, this image is object y plus this y component of translation vector. So vertical translation is very simple. You just need to add the same thing. We have b, so add b. What if we had minus b? Write minus b here. Example of vertical translation. So we just need to add this 5 into y coordinate of this object point to get the image coordinates of image. This is combined translation. So this is plus a, so we need to replace x by x minus a, and we need to add b into resulting equation. So replace x by x minus a and add b. This is the way to get the equation of the resulting graph. Let's suppose we have this equation, and this is the translation vector. So we need to replace all x occurrences by x minus 4 to get the equation of the resulting graph. You have to simplify this. Now, according to this translation vector, we need to replace all x occurrences by x plus 2 and add 3 into resulting equation. So this x is replaced by x plus 2, this x is also replaced by x plus 2, and we added 3 here. You have to simplify this yourself. This is the summary. Transformations types. There are two types of transformations, vertical and horizontal. So vertical, the first one is stretch parallel to y-axis. Vertical stretch means stretch parallel to y-axis with factor a. So if we have this situation And if this is the equation of the object, then we just need to multiply this f of x with this stretch factor to get the equation of the image. And this is the way to get the coordinates of the image point. Vertical reflection. This means reflection about x-axis. So when we reflect anything about x-axis, we just change the sign of y-coordinate. We opposite the sign of y-coordinate. We just need to multiply this with minus 1. Translation, this means vertical translation because x component is 0 of translation vector. So we just need to add b into equation of resulting graph. Horizontal transformations, there are 3 types of horizontal transformations. Horizontal stretch factor a. So remember, to get the equation, use the reciprocal of this. Like, you need to multiply this x with the reciprocal of this stretch factor to get the equation of the resulting graph. But for the coordinates of the image, you should use the same stretch factor here. Horizontal reflection, this means reflection about y-axis. In reflection about y-axis, we opposite the signs of x coordinates. We just need to replace x by minus x. Horizontal translation, you just need to replace x by x minus a, opposite sign. Combined translations. So if we have two vertical transformations, then we use Bodmer to apply the vertical transformations. Bodmer means the normal order. Like, we first do multiplication and then we go for addition. So if two vertical transformations are given, then we use Bodmer. For example, this one. Vertical stretch factor 5 and vertical translation. So we have two vertical transformations. This transformation is of multiplication and this transformation is of addition. So we first apply stretch onto this equation and then we will apply this translation onto the equation. Whatever we equation we would get after this stretch. So first we need to apply this vertical stretch onto this equation. This is the equation of the resulting graph, 5y. So when you will multiply this equation with 5, you will get this equation. Now you have to apply this translation vector onto this equation. You need to add 2 here. This is the way to get the equation of the resulting graph. When two vertical transformations are given, we use Bodmer. Number 2, if two horizontal transformations are given, then we do these transformations in opposite order, opposite to normal order. Like, we first do addition and then we do multiplication. For example, horizontal stretch factor 3 and horizontal translation. This transformation is of addition and this is of multiplication. So first we will apply this and then we will apply this. So when we will apply this onto this equation, we'll get this thing. You all know we need to replace x by x minus 5. So this is the equation of the resulting graph after applying this translation vector onto this equation. Now we have to apply this. Remember, horizontal stretch, in horizontal stretches, we use the reciprocal of the stretch factor to get the equation of the resulting graph. We need to replace this x by x upon 3. Replace x by 1 upon 3x to get the equation of the resulting graph. What if we have one vertical and one horizontal? Then we can do these two in any way. We can either apply horizontal first and vertical second, or vice versa. You can use any order. This is here. This is the other example, I guess. So determine the sequence of transformation. Now this question is very important. Determine the sequence of transformation that maps the curve y is equal to x cube onto this. Now you have to be very careful while finding the sequence. First, you need to observe these two equations carefully. You have to observe the changes here. See, the x is replaced by x plus 5. So this is a horizontal translation with translation vector minus 5, 0. This sign is always opposite in translation vector. And this means vertical stretch, factor half. So first you have to observe both the equations carefully and to identify the types of transformations. So this is vertical stretch and this is horizontal translation. Since we have this thing here, horizontal, vertical, vertical, horizontal, so we can describe this in any way. We can either describe this in HV way or VH way. We can say, in according to HV, way, we can say that translation with vector minus 5, 0 and followed by vertical stretch factor half. We can state this as translation. This is the description. Vector minus 5, 0. Followed by vertical stretch or stretch parallel to y-axis. Factor half. So this is the description according to HV. And this is the logic. I converted this equation into this form. There is no need to convert the equation into this form. This is just for your conceptual clarity. And according to VH sequence, I have to state that it's vertical stretch factor half followed by translation vector minus 5, 0. And I have proved these two things here, that when we have VH or HV, we can describe transformation in any way. And we have got the same equation. If we apply stretch first onto this equation, then we'll get this equation. And then if we will apply this translation, we will get the same answer. So we are getting same answers in both the ways. So when there is HV, we can describe this in any way. Well, this is all. I hope this lecture will help you to summarize the concepts of transformations of functions. An important advice for me and for everyone, we should be good to others. And good luck. Allah Hafiz.